Vihiga County, first of all, it's a rural tourism destination. Rural meaning our predominant activities are agriculture-based, and meaning we still preserve a good chunk of our natural environment.
There's the indigenous people who are the original occupants of the county. These are the Maragulis, the Tiriki, the Terik, and the Bunyore. But then we have also some other communities within Vihiga County. We have the Luos, who are, I think, they neighbor the county from Siaya to Kisumu. And we also border the land of champions, the Nandis. So it's a vast community.
Vihiga, we are fortunate. We are very well placed in that we are right between two former provincial headquarters. We have Kisumu to our south and Kakamega to the north, meaning Vihiga now becomes an ideal getaway destination. Even locally, populations in Kisumu would find it a good adventure to come up to Vihiga. The people in Kakamega as well could easily make it here. And because we are such a small, compact county with so much diversity, again, you can exhaust Vihiga. We have a very good road network. You can exhaust this county in a few days, and you will appreciate the diversity.
Vihiga County is privileged to have some of the most hospitable people in Kenya. And by this, I mean we may not be richly in have invested in the hotel industry, but I would tell you we are richly investing, have invested in homestays, and we are so hospitable and willing to accommodate anyone who is coming to Vihiga County.
Already we are promoting a local tourism, and for example, we have the Foot of Jesus just 3 kilometers from this of the county headquarters. We also have the Rainmakers in Bunyore. We have our Kaimos Forest, and as you are aware, Kaimos Forest, researchers say, is an extension of Congo Forest, but we don't know whether it is indeed an extension of Congo Forest or Congo Forest is an extension of Kaimos Forest.
We have a very rich culture that we need to sell out. We have packaged it very well, and this can sell very, very widely. And we also have very many touristic sites here. We have the Kibiri Forest. Kibiri Forest is one of its kind. We have the Kaimosi Forest, that is the remains of the Congo Forest. It's also a very rich touristic site. There is bird viewing. There are all types of snakes. The smallest monkey in East Africa, I want to believe in Africa, is found in that forest. And therefore, I request everybody around the world to come and witness the amazing features that we have. Kaimosi Forest also has different species of insects, different species of birds. There is amazing bird watching that I want to believe anybody would wish to see.
We still have some of the most authentic cultural practices in the country. If you visit the Tiriki shrines, if you visit the Banyore shrines, if you visit all the shrines we have in the county, and when you look at the fact that we have still preserved our way of conservation, that is why Vihiga, we still have a very high tree cover. We are not suffering from the effects of climate change because these customs have been ingrained in all of us on how to conserve the environment. You'll find also we rarely have issues with insecurity because, again, we are taught to respect people. We understand our traditions to some extent, and I believe in Vihiga, you'll still find authentic culture. Every year we celebrate the Maragoli Cultural Festival, 26th of December. I think I stand corrected again, but it may be the oldest festival in Kenya. I know when I was young, former President Moi was always attending our festivals just to commemorate our rich Maragoli culture. We've got a number of caves. We've got the Mungoma Caves, which is a cultural heritage to the Maragoli people. The Maragoli pay pilgrimage to Mungoma, the cave, because that is the place that Mulogoli, who was the first Maragoli man, settled and made his home. The population grew from Mulogoli and his family at Mungoma. Every year we pay tribute to the Maragoli people at the Mungoma Caves. Just adjacent to Mungoma we've got the belt of hills that stretch from Maseno right across the county into Nandi. They have different names at different points. We've got the Amabungo, then the Maragoli Hills, we've got Muzazi, which is also called Kapkoros, and it extends right up to Nandi, right across the county. So our county now becomes a very great destination for hiking, for scenery, because once you get to the top of our hills, I do believe that we have the best view of Lake Victoria and the Kisumu region, the western region, from the top of our hills. That, I am certain that we are unmatched anywhere else in the world. So for scenic views, for nice picnics, for good hiking, for nice forest eco-tours, these are some of the products we're offering in Vihiga County.
If you go around Vihiga County, you'll see we have opened up all the feeder roads. All of them, they have all become all seasons road. When it rains, you can't get stuck the way we used to have those problems in yesteryears. So with the opening up of the infrastructure, really it has helped our people to improve on the marketing strategies in this county.
I would like to stress that we are not just a nature-based destination. Vihiga County, largely we have produced a lot of talent, especially in the sporting sector. I would like to bring to your attention, in case you did not know, that when we look at the Kenya Sevens rugby team, for example, I know people say that these are luyas, but I want to correct you and bring it closer and tell you that these are actually people of Vihiga County, the communities within Vihiga County, a large part of them. When we talk about Collins Injera, we talk about his brother Humphrey Kayange, we talk about Biko Adema, we talk about Oscar Ayodi, William Baka, all these players have their roots here. We have Felix Ayange also. These are people who have their DNA and are descendants of the communities of Vihiga County. This means that Vihiga, being as small as we are, can easily produce a national rugby team. Easily. And there's a lot more where they came from, because every year we are churning out new talent. Recently, the former captain, last year's captain of Vihiga High School, Colin Shikoli, is now playing in the national team, and he went to Amsterdam. And that's what we are saying, that every year we want to keep supplying the national teams with quality talent that is born and bred and owes its heritage to Vihiga County. And not just in rugby. A former legend of football, Joe Kadenge, again, he lives here, he resides here, and we're always spending time with him. He attends our functions. Again, that's another legend from the county, right? I also like the Malkia Strikers. The Malkia Strikers, the Kenya women's volleyball team. And we're also proud to report that the captain, Braxides Agala, again, is also a descendant. She's part of the community that comprises Vihiga County. So these are some of the products that we are looking to inform the public that even if people want to invest in sports, tourism, you want to invest in nature, you want to invest in culture, we have the Tiriki circumcision ceremony that is arguably the most authentic cultural practice remaining in Kenya today, right? When they're doing their ceremony, they still practice the traditional, original way of doing things that they practiced it before. And therefore, as Vihiga, as small as we are inviting you for great adventure. We are inviting you to experience biodiversity. We are inviting you to witness real sporting talent. And we are just inviting you to enjoy natural landscape and real nature. Finally, I'd like to add that Vihiga, because we are well connected in this region and we are an access, we serve as a connecting county to many major centers. It would be good for people to know that even while residing in Vihiga, you can still access our neighboring attractions. From Vihiga County, Lake Victoria is only half an hour away. From Vihiga County, Kakamega Forest is also less than half an hour away. You can experience many other attractions in our neighboring counties, in Nandi and Siaya, while still residing in Vihiga. The climate is very good. It's cool. It's not excessively hot. And I think a lot of people would find it very comfortable staying in Vihiga, even if you wanted to go out into other areas in the region. I think Vihiga, you will experience real comfort and real hospitality.